This is one of the most exciting developments in bike fitting. We've got two things at work here. We have a bike on a Compi trainer, which gives us a resistance that we can change to simulate a real-world load. It also allows us to analyze the power output separately on the left and the right leg and how even your pedal stroke is. In conjunction with that, we have this new system called BG Data, made by Specialized Bicycles. It's a 3D video capture fitting system. You take the outfit from two cameras, one front and one side. You take video of your riding under real-world loads, and then we can use the on-screen tools to analyze what's going on while you're actually riding your bike. Now, this is the spin scan analysis of the CompuTrainer. Basically, what this is telling us is this is the left pedal stroke, the right pedal stroke. If we look down here, we can see that the left side is putting out 48% of the power and the right side 52. This circle here tells us how smooth your pedal stroke is. So from the beginning of the pedal stroke to the end on the left side, and from the beginning of the pedal stroke to the end on the right side. The rounder this circle is, the smoother and more effective your pedal stroke is. The way we use this spin scan is to see if our fitting has actually made your pedal stroke more efficient. So we take a look at it before we start making any changes on the bike, then we'll do some spot checks in between, and then when we think we have your fit really dialed in, we'll take another look at the spin scan and see where we've ended up. This is Carrie. Carrie is on her bike on the Compi trainer, and we put some markers on her leg so it will help us analyze her fit. We put a marker on the hip socket, we put one at the spot where her knee pivots, and we put one on the ankle. Now, we put Carrie under load, and then we record it on video, and then we can take that video and analyze it on screen using the markers as a guide. We're looking at the playback of the video we just recorded with Carrie on her bike. So we've got it in slow motion, and we've got it looping. We can see the three markers that we put on her legs, and that's going to help us analyze exactly how high her seat should be and how far forward or back it should be. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a reference line so we can see exactly when the pedal stroke is going to be at the very bottom, and that's when the pedals are lined up with the seat tube. I'm going to freeze the video right there. Once I have that in place, I'm going to remove that line. And now I'm going to draw, just connect these three dots. And that's going to tell us the angle of the knee at the bottom of the pedal stroke. We've already fit Carrie, so what we see here is that the angle of her knee is almost exactly what we'd like it to be ideally. And also if we look at the angle of her ankle, relative to the floor at the bottom of the pedal stroke, it's relatively flat. So that gives her a good power on the bottom of her power stroke. We're now looking at the real-time speed, and what we're looking at is to see what's happening to the upper body when Carrie is pedaling. What we see is a little bit of hip rocking back to back, side to side. There's two things that can cause this. One is if the seat were too high, which in this case it's not. The second is if the core muscles aren't developed as much as they should be, then that's something we need to work on. It's also important to know what things we can fix with a fitting and what things we can't fix, so we can recommend to someone that they see a physical trainer or a therapist or a massage person. In a full fitting, we use the massage table to take some flexibility measurements. We measure how much certain parts of your body bend, we write down the angle, and then we can compare that to what we see on the bike. For instance, I'm going to do a leg raise here where I let Carrie's leg bend at the knee. And I'm going to see how far I can push this before her hips start to rotate or her other leg starts to come up. Once I find that spot, I'm going to measure it with this tool, which is called a goniometer. And that will give me the maximum angle of hip flexion. I've taken the video of Carrie on her bike, and I've frozen it with her left leg at the highest point. Now this basically is duplicating what I did with Carrie on the table. So if I measured an angle of Carrie's leg, the maximum hip flexion, if it's going to be greater than 80 degrees, then she can pedal there. But if she can only bend her leg less than 80 degrees, then the bike is going to be set up improperly. That means we either have to raise her handlebar so she sits up more, or we have to change the height of the seat.
This is the most exciting part of the 3D fitting, and that is we're going to take some measurements and then we're going to relate it to what we see in the front plane of the bike. So here we're measuring what we call the 4-foot angulation. How much do the front of Carrie's feet tilt in, or tilt out in this case, toward the outside of her feet? So we can see that on the left side we've got a slight tilt and the right side a little bit more. This is the 1/3 knee bend test. We're going to ask Carrie to lift her left leg up and to go down 1/3 of the way on the right. Then we're going to look and see what happens to her right knee. As you can see, the right knee points in. Now we've attached some markers to the front of Carrie's knees. We're going to use this to look at the front dimension of the bike, or what Specialized calls the third dimension, to see what happens with the knee tracking when she's pedaling under load. Now we're going to analyze the video of Carrie from the third dimension, or the front camera. And we're going to take and use these two tracking lines to see what happens to her knees as she goes around the pedal stroke. So what you can see very clearly is, as the pedal comes up on the back side, the neutral side, the knee goes out away from the bike. Then as power is applied to that foot, the knee comes in toward the middle of the bike. And it's pretty much even on both sides. So if we really want to give Carrie a great bicycling experience so that she can ride pain-free for a lot of miles, we've got to correct this. We can also relate this to what we saw when we did the 1/3 knee bend test and the 4-foot angulation measurement. What's happening essentially is that because the foot wants to roll toward that part that's raised as you apply pressure to it, it pulls the knee in with it. Solving the problem of making the knees track straight is very complicated, and there's a number of things that we might have to try to get rid of it. But we're going to take a close look at the shoe, the pedals, and the cleats, and also the footbed. So first we're going to measure and make sure that the cleats are in the right position for the shape of Carrie's foot. And then we're going to move them from side to side until we get her feet to line up with the width of her hips. Then we're going to take a look at the footbed. Carrie's arches are high. We're going to put a footbed in there that takes up that space so the arch doesn't collapse on the downstroke. The last thing we're going to correct is if Carrie's feet angle to the outside, which we can see from the test, and it's affecting her knee, we're going to take one of these shims and we're going to put it inside the footbed. That way, as the foot comes down on the pedal stroke, that empty space that would be created is filled by the shim, which is fatter on one side than the other. We always work on the bike, we adjust them from the back to the front. It's very important to get the seat height and the seat setback set properly first, because this prevents injury to the knees. Once we've done that though, we want to take a look at the front end of the bike. Now, a lot of people complain of back pain, lower back pain, neck pain on the bike. This is usually because the handlebars are either too low or they're too far away. We need to make sure that we get Carrie's center of gravity to such a point where about 60% of her weight is over the rear wheel and 40% is over the front wheel. If we can keep that balance and keep her shoulders relaxed and keep the elbows a little bit bent, then we get the weight in the right place so there's not too much weight down her hands and there's also not too much weight going down her spine. We can also use the video to help us try and analyze why there might be some lower back pain or neck pain. We can take those angles that we measured on the massage table and we can see how that matches with the upper back angle, the shoulder angle. And again, if we exceed those things by putting the handlebars too low, then we can almost guarantee there's going to be back pain. It's very important to set the bike up for the way someone is built, not for some theoretical ideal about the way a bike should look. For instance, I happen to have very long arms, so if you look at my handlebars, they look really low compared to the seat, and yet I sit fairly upright. I can take someone else whose handlebars look pretty high compared to the seat. Maybe they're the same height or even higher, but their back angle is a lot lower. Their physiology is just different. So we have to match the bike fit to the person and how you are at that time, how flexible your body is. Your body changes over time. Your fit's going to change over time.